Well, hey everybody, it cometh a egg, just doing a long overdue video because it's been a while. I've had some nice pickups, been to a few card shows, and even won a contest on a legendary YouTuber's channel. So wanted to show off some cards, give a quick shout out to my buddy Joe and any insomniacs that might be watching. And well, hell, let's jump right into it. Also, I got new stickers on the channel. I got new official sticker here promoting the old YouTube channel. If you see me on Facebook, I've been using that image for a while. And then what's it called, Sticker Mule did their thing, 10 stickers for $1. So I got this cool one of Scott over at Reindeer Studios because he sent me that picture when I first got the t-shirts, and he's universally liked, so I figured it would be a cool sticker. But I already gave those few of them out, gave them away, so your chance to get those are already gone. Scott's is in the mail. Figured it'd be a good idea, you know? And figured, you know, copyright infringing being what it is and all. But anyway, I got this cool card. That was like a Adam Sandler rookie card, you know? I'm old enough to remember a time when Saturday Night Live was the funniest show on TV. Imagine that. Imagine a time when Saturday Night Live was the funniest show, was the tastemaker show, was the standard bearer, the funny show on TV. And even the funniest part of their show was the fake TV commercials that they would show when it was time for them to run TV commercials. I won a contest. I won a giveaway on Hard R's channel. He's renamed the channel Rocky's Old Man, which is great because Rocky Lemon, the hottest young catcher in baseball, and what he was given away was a sick, was that Cognac Diamond Edition card? From 2011 Tops Update. And I love that. I think 2011 Tops was like one of the coolest set designs. I love the Cognac editions. I love all the things about the set. Here's the famous Mike Trout that came out of that Fairfield video that I did about 7 years ago or so, or whatever, 6, 7 years ago. I did that Fairfield Walgreens repack video. The Trout, Chris Sale, man, talk about, if he doesn't win the Cy Young this year, okay, but definitely comeback player of the year. Man, everyone thought this guy's career was over and done with. Let's talk about these Diamond Edition 2011 Tops cards and how sick they look. But man, Chris Sale having a career year out of the gutter. A sick card. And then this guy's still throwing heat, man. Freaking whatever, 15 years into his career. And that's the Sparkle, little Sparkle edition here. Back when Series 1 of 2011 came out, he was the hot rookie. Aroldis Chapman was the hot young rookie you could get in Series 1. That was the card you were hoping for. And this was the whatever, one per case Sparkle edition. So I just love 2011 Tops. And the question you had to answer was, what is Dan's favorite present-day female wrestler? Which, you know, he likes the Charlotte Flair. But these are underrated cards, man. Got Lou Gehrig with all the career stats on the back. Got my boy Yogi. Phil Rizzuto. Pee-wee Reese. These are just great-looking cards. So I've been picking them up for a while. For a while. So, you know, Yogi Berra, I had to pick up this sweet Wheaties box cutout from back in the day. I think this is 52. So when you were opening up your packs of 52 Topps cards back in the day, eating your cereal in the morning, and I wasn't going to pick up this card as part of my Yogi Berra playing days run. But then I saw that documentary they did on him on Netflix. And that show, that card is featured in the beginning. And I thought it was cool and I wanted to make it part of my run. So I did. So I picked that up. Also picked up this card. Daryl Strawberry's old Tidewater Tides card. Freaking, that was a card I always wanted as a kid growing up, and it was always super expensive in the display case at the card shop. Don't you love when you PC a guy and you find a sweet card that's in the dollar bin? Yeah, Kazam, a Shaq. Look at that. Coming in July of 96. Shaq in his first movie role. Come on. This is crazy. That just screams good times. Good times, good times, man. That should be a video all its own. I got a couple more cards, but let's jump into this sick. I feel so patriotic opening this. Man, I used to use my founding father's luck. All right, so I mentioned, I'll leave a link in the description below. Great channel called Rocky's Old Man. Egg, you won. Dan and Rocky. Oh, gentlemen, just always gentlemen. Here we go. Rocky, as I said, best young catcher in the... And that's not my card. That's Ricochet. Sweet. New AEW superstar, Ricochet. I like his girlfriend or wife or whatever it might be. But autographed Rocky Lemon rookie card. Hell yeah. Playing catcher, the toughest position in baseball. And, you know, that's why I collect Yogi Berra. But sweet, man. Wasn't expecting a Ricochet on card auto. And that's not all that's in the pack. I got some more goodies in here. This is taped up really well. Here we go. This is the only card I thought I was getting. Official Ty Cobb Diamond Edition. Talking about those 2011 sick tops. I got Lita. Hold on now. What do I got here? Lita from back in the WWF days. Ultimate Warrior rookie card, I believe. And happy Father's Day. It's Chris Benoit. For instance, I did just do a video that I got my Chris Benoit in-person autograph authenticated. So I'm not going to pretend that I was not an admirer of Benoit for his entire career up until that last weekend. Alex Verdugo, do not have a autograph of New York Yankees superstar Alex Verdugo with all the tattoos. And speaking of a tatted up dude, Damian Priest, NXT card. I'll call that a rookie. So sweet, yeah. The little contest that I won there, which really was a default win, he didn't have to give me anything, but that was just for the Ty Cobb. So awesome, man. Thanks. And let me also give a shout out to awesome good friend of the channel, Steve, over at Purple GT. Again, I'll leave a link in the description. He had a an auction a while ago, and I picked up a Aaron Judge rookie card that I did not have. I think that was from Topps Online because it's got that rainbow shine on the back. But I get a Judge rookie that I didn't have for the collection, but I got other cards, but I can't show them because they are for friends of mine that are Atlanta Braves collectors, my son's godparents. But also, you know, I do the MagPro things, the make your own slab things, and I am not that handy with the printer and all. So my boy made me up some Ikumafa egg slabs here. And check these out. If I mean, for fuck's sake, seriously. Look at these. I mean, some have Andre the Giant's face on a world title belt. Some have a hard-boiled and a cracked egg right there. But some beautiful Ikumafa egg slabs there for the collection. Which I know that these MagPro cases are going to become the new freaking... going to take over my collection here. Which is a good thing. Other pickups here. Weird wrestling rookie cards thing. I got Max Dupree and John Moxley rookie card. I didn't have them, you know. I'm seeing this guy, you know, autographing as Max Dupree. Now we know him as LA Knight. I would have taken an Eli Drake for the win. And Moxley, what is he going to do? Is he going to bring in Shane McMahon and take over AEW? If you're not a pro wrestling fan, do you even know what these acronyms mean? Do you know what I'm talking about? Is it crazy? I picked up a Derek Jeter patch, a dirty patch. Sweet game used base patch, GU1. I think it's sick because it shows you the base that it was used. It tells you in 2001, there was only 500 produced off of this base. And then just me being a Yankees fan, remember when the lineup card looked like this? Chuck Knoblauch, Derek Jeter, David Justice, Bernie Williams, Tino Martinez, Jorge Posada, Paul O'Neill, Scott Brosius, Alfonso Soriano, signed by manager Joe Torre. Just a great card. Love that card. Love adding it to the collection. Love this insane community. Check out the links in the description below for tons of great people. And remember, as always, it come of egg.